This, what you see, is a brushless DC motor. You can see the three wires for the three phases. And this small black wire, this is the neutral wire, which means that the windings are star connected and not delta connected. And you can also see that I've connected this chuck so that you can see its rotation easily. You can see that it's quite smooth. And it's from an old photocopy machine or a Xerox machine. So today in this video, I'm going to use this motor and demonstrate its performance with just a single computer UPS transformer, no other component, none at all. This video is just for demonstration so that you can learn, research, and maybe one day add more to it. So here I have connected the brushless motor to the vise. And now that everything is connected, simply choose any of the two wires from the three phases, not the neutral one, the three phases. So I'm choosing the middle one and the lower one. And as I said, right now the switch is turned off. Okay, so everything is fine. Yeah, and now let's turn it on and see what happens. Okay, go. There is humming, but no rotation. Now, this is just a single phase connection and it is not starting. So what we have to do is we have to give it a spin. And that is because right now we are only activating one phase. So there is no starting. It is working like an AC motor. So let's turn it on once again and give it a spin. You see? Faster. You see? That now it is running much faster. Pretty cool. It is running like a single phase AC motor with pretty good torque. See, it is not stopping. Let's say that you want to reverse the rotation. See, reverse rotation. See, it is really difficult to stop. Oh. Torque is extremely high. I can only imagine that if all the three phases are active, then the torque is going to be much more stronger. And here, as you can see, that we are getting around 750 rotations per minute. Now, this motor is 24 volts DC, while for the transformer, it is only 6 to 7 volts AC. Now, the question that could be arising, an exciting one, is what if we use a 24 volts transformer instead of this tiny, puny computer UPS transformer that can only output 6 volts? And at 6 volts, the motor is running at 750 rotations per minute. And if we connect this 24 volts transformer, then since the voltage is going to be 4 times higher, then the output RPM for the motor is also going to be 4 times higher, right? Well, let's answer this after doing the current measurement for the current UPS transformer. Now, if we check the drawn amperes, we can see that it is drawing around 8 amperes AC. And this motor is rated at 24 volts, 5 amperes. So it is drawing much more, which means high losses. And if we try loading the motor, like stopping it, you can see that the amperes start to reduce. Right now it is drawing around 8 amperes, and if I try to stop it, you can see that the amperes are reducing. Although it's going to as low as 6.5 amps, and after that it is losing synchronism. Let's turn it off. So here I have the 24 volts transformer. Let's connect the wires. And we have to connect only two. So one is already connected, the other one is left. Now the transformer is on and all I need to do is connect this wire to one of the two remaining wires and see what happens. Oh, you see? Oh! You see so much drawn current. So let's measure it first. Let's connect the wires and see for real. 35 amperes, you saw? Whoa! So this much current is definitely going to damage either the windings of the motor or the transformer itself. And one more thing, because the transformer is rated at 10 amperes only, so this motor is actually acting as a short circuit for this transformer. And this is happening when I've connected these thin wires just for testing and safety. Now I'm about to tell you something extremely important. Imagine that these three scales represent the three phase winding of this brushless motor, and the windings are connected in the star format, right? Okay, so the transformer right now is powering only one phase, right? While the other two phases are inactive, and you have already seen the result of that, the RPM and the torque. Now, what will happen if I'm successfully able to operate all the three phases in such a way that it is able to run the brushless motor without ESC? Yes, that is what is the important announcement, and I will be uploading the video soon. So let me know in the comment section who is interested.